video we are going to solve this problem cavity map. So I'll read the statements first. You are given a square map as a matrix of integer strings. Each cell of map has a value denoting its depth. We will call a cell of map a cavity if and only if this cell is not on the border of the map and each cell adjacent to it has a strictly smaller depth. Two cells are adjacent if they have a common side or edge. And find all the cavities on the map and replace their depth with the uppercase character X. So here you will see we have been given a grid array containing integer strings. So this is first integer string, this is second, and this is third. So the grid will be rearranged like this. The first string will be arranged on the first line, second on second, third on third. So we'll see here they have given condition that a cell is a cavity if and only if it is not on the border of the map. So you will see that this first line is on the border, this last line is on the border, and this 9, this one on the second string, and this one on the second string is on the border, that is which is forming the square. So only 9 has the chance of being a cavity. So here we have to check one more condition, that the adjacent cell should have a strictly smaller depth. So you will see this depth is 9 and the adjacent depths are 1, this right side is 1, the left side is also 1, the bottom one is 1 and upper one is 8. So it is satisfying both the conditions, as 9 is not on the border and adjacent all the cells are having lesser depth. So that's why they have replaced this 9 with the X. So that's all we have to do. So in the function we'll get a string grid. Each string represents a row of a grid, and we have to return the modified grid, that is with inserting X, capital X. So here is another example. So this is the grid size, that is 4x4 grid, and in the grid we'll get these values, and we have to check for all the non-border cavities, that is we have to neglect whichever numbers are forming the square, that is this first line, last line, and the line which is forming a horizontal line, that is this whole 111 and this whole 2 and 4. So having a cavity which are satisfying the cavity conditions are only 9, 1, 8 and 9, the middle part of it, that is this 9, this 9, the adjacent 1, this 9 and this adjacent 8. For these 4 elements we have to check the conditions if their adjacent elements are having smaller depth or not. So here you will see for this first 9, the adjacent elements cavity are 1, 1, 1 and 8. So that's why it is a cavity. So we'll fill that element with X, capital X. And for this 9, adjacent elements are 2, this 3, 8 and 1. So that 2 is following the both the 2 conditions, that is it is not on the border and it the adjacent depths are smaller than it its own depth, that is that's why it is a cavity. So that these two conditions we have to check in the code. So I'll go into the code. Here you will see there are 3 parameters they have given, that is grid count, grid and result count. So grid count will be equal to the size of the grid, that is if it is a 4x4 grid then the grid count will be 4, and this is the actual grid, and the result count which we have to return. So the result count will be equal to the grid count. So result count will be equal to grid count, and as I have said earlier that we have to check for 2 conditions, that it should not be on the border and the elements the adjacent element should have a smaller value than the current element itself. So as you will see that this is a character pointer grid. So it is a 2D array, so that's why we'll need a for loop inside a for loop. So I'll start a for loop from I equal to 0. No, I have to start the for loop from I equal to 1, as we don't have to include the border elements. That is these border elements, that is the elements which are forming the square. So that elements we have to neglect. So I'll start the for loop from I equal to 1. I'll end the for loop from grid count minus 1. So in this way, neglect the border elements, and I'll give the modification. So we have to declare this I, and we'll need another variable for inner for loop. So I'm declaring it there itself, that is for inner for loop. So I've declared I and J here for the for loops, and inside this outer for loop, I'll declare one more for loop that from starting from J equal to 1 to avoid the border elements. And J will be less than equal to grid count minus 1 for the same purpose of avoiding the border elements and the modification at the end of the for loop, that is J plus plus. So what we have to do now, as we have avoided the border elements by initiation of this for loop and by giving the condition of it, that is we have initialized the for loop with 1 on the both the for loops, and we have given the condition as grid count minus 1. So by these conditions, it will never go to the border elements. So after that, what we have to check is if the current element is having the adjacent element depth is low, that we have to check if the current element is having more depth than its adjacent element. So the current element will be grid of I J should have a greater depth than its left side element, that is grid of I J minus 1. So J minus 1 will be its left side element, and same accordingly check the right side element, that is grid of I J should be greater than grid of I J plus. This condition is checking the right side element, and after that we'll check the upper element, that grid of I J greater than grid of I minus 1. Is checking the upper element, and the bottom element will be checked by grid of I J be greater than grid of I plus 1 J. So in this if statement, we have checked four conditions. If all the four conditions are satisfying, then we'll get to know that element, which is the current element, that is grid of I J, is cavity. So at that point we have to insert x. So that we will do by assigning x to that position. Basically we are just traversing the grid array, which is a 2D array. As you will see, there are two pointers here, so we are traversing the grid array, and we are neglecting the border elements by initializing with 1 and giving the condition as grid count minus 1. And after that, we are checking four conditions. That is, we have to check if the current element is having greater value, that is greater cavity. That means current element should have a greater value than its adjacent element. So we are checking its left element, its right element, its upper element, and its bottom element. And if all the conditions are satisfying, then at that point we are putting x. So by after completion of this outer for loop, we'll insert x onto all the positions. After that, we have to just return the grid. As you will see, the return type is also character pointer, that is 2D array. So after that, we'll run the code to check all the conditions. We will see first two test cases are passed. We'll submit the code. So all the test cases are passing. So if you have any doubts in this code, do let me know in comments. And thank you for watching. And please subscribe for more videos.